Chapter 1. The Glorious Sun. Darkness shrouded the spires of the castle and enveloped the kingdom. Every corner and curve of the shimmering buildings of Canterlot was covered in the sheen of moonlight. It was a subtle beauty, but a comforting one. Normally, the graceful blue alicorn felt perfectly at ease during this hour, but tonight was a different story. Tonight had social obligations. "For Celestia," Princess Luna whispered, reminding herself. She took a deep breath to calm her nerves and peered around the corner of the castle's back gate. There were hundreds of ponies spilling out on the lawn. Ponies from all over Equestria were here in the capital for Luna's most dreaded night of the moon, the summer sun celebration. Every pony in Equestria loved the annual event. It was supposed to be a joyous occasion to acknowledge Luna's own return from her lengthy exile as Nightmare Moon, when she transformed back into her true self some moons ago. At least, that's what Princess Celestia had assured her. But all Princess Luna could see now was a reminder of her past mistakes. It was not something she liked to relive. Luna knew that the summer sun celebration had existed prior to her return, and back then, it was started to celebrate her own sister's triumph over her. Ooh. Wait, really? Ouch. Oh my god, ouch. I didn't know that's why I was invented. Damn, Celestia. Sheesh. Drilling in much? But now she was a leader of Equestria once more, and it was her duty to show her face as the guest of honor. The citizens would expect her to smile and wave, like Twilight, making a rare appearance outside of the ones she made in her dreams, in their dreams. A group of palace guards trotted past. Luna could tell they were searching for her. She could delay no longer. It was time. Luna made her way toward the crowd, filled with a sense of dread.
"Thou mayest escort me to the celebration stage," Princess Luna bellowed at the guards.
Startled, they whipped their heads toward her, ruffling the blue plumes on their helmets. She cleared her throat, once again surprised by her own voice's volume. Luna lowered her head, and her sparkling blue mane flowed forward.
"Excuse me, I kindly beg your pardon, officers. At large events, I often use the royal Canterlot voice. Old habits."
Luna forced a congenial laugh. They smiled back, but she could tell she'd scared them.
"Not again,"
she thought.
"It's no problem, princess," said Glimmering Shield, bowing. "Follow me."
Luna nodded to convey her gratitude, but didn't speak. She didn't want to make any pony else nervous. The way Glimmering Shield kept looking back at her over his shoulder as they trotted to the stage made her feel awkward enough. Even after all this time, social skills were something that didn't come as easily to her as they did to Princess Celestia. As if she could read Luna's mind, Celestia appeared in front of her.
"Sister!"
she exclaimed, her eyes sparkling with delight. The tall white alicorn moved toward her, the gold crown atop her head catching the light. It was Princess Celestia's favorite day.
That's just so sad. "Welcome to the celebration. Every pony is very excited to spend time with you this evening."
They are? Luna asked, scanning the massive crowd. Most of the ponies in sight seemed to be staring at Celestia in admiration. They wore blue, green, and purple ribbons in their manes and waved little pennant flags with a picture of the sun on them, just like her sister's famous cutie mark.
Well, that kind of sucks. Shouldn't they be waving, like, the official equestrian flag that has both sisters on it now that she's returned? Just saying.
When their eyes drifted over to Luna, their expressions were a mixture of curious and frightened.
"Eek." "Of course,"
Celestia answered. She gestured her gold-plated hoof at the crowd.
Gold-plated hoof? Are they trying to suggest that those are actually not, like, shoes, that it's actually her hoof? Whatever.
"Besides, it's one of the only nights of moon when every pony get to see us together. For some reason,
They are still always surprised when you aren't in attendance at the Grand Galloping Gala.
Celestia laughed, and her almond-shaped eyes crinkled at the corners.
But I never go. Luna smiled back. Why would I change that now?
She always loved hearing Princess Celestia's stories about the gala each moon, but Luna was very glad that her night shift allowed her to decline attendance. Fancy dresses and small talk were not her idea of a pleasurable evening, though the story from this moon about Discord bringing the smooze had sounded quite amusing. The chatter of the crowd gathering nearby in Canterlot's main square was growing louder with each passing minute. They were getting excited. Soon it would be time for the morning, and Celestia would break the dawn by raising the sun. She would fly up to the sky, spreading her wings, and use her powerful magic in front of everypony. Until then, Princess Luna couldn't help but feel odd about the fact that the time that normally belonged to her, the peaceful, silent night, was being disrupted. It was just one night.
Almost time, Princess Celestia nudged Luna. Are you ready, sister?
We are prepared to proceed with the Summer Sun Celebration Ceremony, Luna thundered.
The two sisters stepped onto the stage and were enthralled by the sight of the joyous citizens of their kingdom and the stars twinkling above.